Hello, good evening. Welcome back to today's online class. I am Radhika, your politics teacher. Children, we will study politics chapter 21, secular vision of the Indian constitution. We are discussing about a fundamental right. There are six fundamental rights. That is, right to equality, right to freedom, right against exploitation, right to freedom of religion, cultural and educational right, right to constitutional remedies. From this right, we completed right to equality and right to freedom. Today's your topic is right against exploitation. The Indian Constitution recognizes the dignity of the individual and protect him or her against any form of exploitation. The Indian Constitution recognizes the dignity of the individual. The Constitution's guarantee or recognizing or protecting the dignity of the individual from any form of exploitation. And this right against exploitation is enshrined in Article 23 and 24 in the Constitution of India. Article 23 and 24, the right to exploitation clearly prohibits. That means Article 23 and 24 enshrine the right against exploitation in the Constitution of India. And this right to exploitation clearly prohibits trafficking in human beings. Then what is the meaning of trafficking? Trafficking means selling and buying of human beings for immoral purposes. That is called trafficking. What is trafficking? Selling and buying of human beings. Normally we are selling and buying products or things, is it children? But in some time we are buying and selling human beings for immoral purposes. That is called trafficking. Under this right means which right? Under right against exploitation clearly prohibit means what? Stopped what? Trafficking in human beings. Next, right to exploitation clearly prohibits bonded labor. You know what is the meaning of bonded labor? Forced labor done without payment. That means they are forcing the labor to do the work without giving anything. Without giving anything means without payment of any wages in return. This is called a bonded labor. Clearly, this also prohibited under right to exploitation. The right to exploitation clearly prohibit bonded labor or forced labor done without payment. And next, employment of children below the age of 14 is strictly prohibited. Children below the age of 14 is not allowed to do any employment. They are not allowed to do any job under some persons. Okay, that also prohibited under right to exploitation. Then, adolescents between 14 and 18 years cannot be employed in any hazardous occupation. Hazardous means dangerous. That means mining, coring, that cracker making, that type of hazardous, dangerous occupation. The 14 to 18 years children not allowed to do the working that areas. these are prohibited through article, sorry, the through which right? Right to exploitation. Right to exploitation, not a right against exploitation. Okay, children. Today we discussed about the right against exploitation. The Indian Constitution recognizes the dignity of the individual and protects him or her against by any form of exploitation. This is very clearly enshrined in Article 23 and 24 of the Constitution of India. The Article 23 and 24, the right to exploitation clearly prohibits four things. Which all are that? First one, trafficking in human beings. Second, bonded labor, that means forced labor done without payment. And third, employment of children below the age of 14 is strictly prohibited. And adolescents between 14 to 18 years cannot be employed in any hazardous occupation. Clear, children? Okay. Next, right to freedom of religion. This is the fourth right. Right to freedom of religion. The Constitution guarantees the right to freedom of religion under Article 25 to 28. The Constitution guarantees right to freedom of religion under Article 25 to 28, according to which all religions are equal before the law. Clear, children? According to our Constitution, in our country, all religions are treating in an equal manner. The Constitution guarantees the right to freedom of religion under Article 25 to 28, according to which all religions are equal before the law. Okay, children. Let's see what all are the religious freedom we have. First one, every person has the right to profess, practice, and propagate the religion he or she believes in. First one, every person, all citizen in our country, all the citizen in our country has the right to profess. Profess means claim that one has. This is the meaning of profess. Okay, every person has their right to profess and practice and propagate. Propagate means flourishing. Flourishing means what? Distributing or spreading. Okay, spreading the religion he or she believes in. Okay, next, every religious community has a right to establish institutions for religious and charitable purpose. Okay, every religious community has the right to establish institution for religious and a charitable purpose. For example, temple, then a charitable trust, like that. They can, according to the name of religion, they can set up. Okay, according to the name of religion, the person have a right to set up institutions. Then, no citizen can be denied admission in any educational institution managed or aided by the state on the basis of religion, caste or race. Okay, children, that means the citizen cannot be denied admission in any educational institution in the name of religion. Clear? Because of that community or because of this religion, no person in our country have a right to deny the right of other people. Clear? Clear, children? Once again, the Constitution guarantees the right to freedom of religion under Article 25 to 28, according to which all religions are equal before the law. Every person has the right to profess, practice, and propagate the religion he or she believes in. Every religious community has the right to establish institution for religious and charitable purpose and to manage its affairs. No citizen can be denied admission in any educational institution managed or aided by the state on the basis of religion, caste, or race. The Constitution prohibits the imparting of religious instructions in schools run by the state or receives aid from the state. The Constitution prohibits this also. The school which is run by the government have no right to impart any religious instructions. Impart means make it. Religious instructions in the school. Which type of school? The school is run by the government. Government schools. Okay, children. Today we discussed about two rights. First one, right against exploitation. Right against exploitations enshrined in Constitution from Article 23 and 24. And this right clearly prohibit trafficking in human beings, for bonded labor, that means forced labor done without payment. And the third, employment of children below the age of 14 is strictly prohibited. And adolescents between the 14 to 18 cannot be employed in any hazardous occupation. Then after we discussed about right to freedom of religion. The Constitution guarantees the right to freedom of religion under Article 25 to 28, according to which all religions are equal before the law. Every person has the right to profess, practice, and propagate the religion he or she believes in. Every religious community has the right to establish institution for religious and charitable purpose. No citizen can be denied admission in any educational institution managed or aided by the state. Clear, children? And one more thing also, the Constitution prohibits the imparting of religious instructions in school run by the government. Okay, children, I am going to stop here. See you.